Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to download and install Java, and also I will show you how to set up Visual Studio Code for Java and run your first program. So let's get started. Just go to Google and type Java JDK download and you'll be getting the first link as Java downloads. Just click that. It is from oracle.com, and here we will be having Java 20 and Java 17. And Java 20 is the latest version of Java, the latest JDK version. So you can just go here, scroll down, you'll be having it for different operating systems. We are going to download it for Windows. Just click on Windows, and here you'll be having MSI installer. So just click on that. So it is about 158 MB in size. So just be patient till that. So once the download is completed, just click on open. You need to click on next, and you can just change the location if you want to. The default is fine for me, so I'll just click on next. So the installation will begin. That's it. So once the installation is complete, you will be getting this successfully installed message. Just click on close. So now we need to add our Java path to the environment variables. All right. So just go to the folder where you have installed Java. So by default, it's going to be C, program files, Java JDK 20, and you'll be having this bin thing. So you need to copy the till bin folder. Just control C, just go to search and type environment. You'll be getting the edit the system environment variables option. Just click on open, and in this you'll be having here environment variables. Click that, and under system variables, just click on path, edit. You need to click on new, and you need to just paste this. Alright, you need to have till bin folder, and just click on OK everywhere. Now just open your command prompt, just zoom it. So we need to run the command java hyphen hyphen version and hit enter. So here you can see that I'm getting Java 20, which is the latest version of Java that we have installed right now. So you'll be getting this message if you have done the installation process in a perfect way. So in case if you aren't getting this, you must have made a mistake in the path. So just try checking that path. So now we are good. Let me just close this. And in case if you want to add Java home, what you can do is you can just go to the same environment variables, edit environment variables. Here you can just click on new, and you can just have it as Java underscore home. And you can just, you know, paste the path. I think for Java home, we need to paste till JDK 20. You can just click on OK. So this is optional. If you want, you can do this Java home thing. In most of the cases, it is not at all necessary. So I will just remove this. In my case, it is not needed. So I will just now delete this. All right. If you want, you can have it. So now we are done installing Java. So let's just go and try running a Java program. So just go to Google and type download Visual Studio Code. You will be getting the first link over here as codevisualstudio.com. Just click that. And here you will be having Visual Studio Code for different OS. There is for Windows, Linux, and Mac. I'm going to download it for Windows. So I'll just click on this Windows, okay? So download will get automatically started. So it is about 88.8 MB in size. So just be patient. So once the download is complete, just click on open. And you'll be getting like this license agreement. Just click on I accept. You can just scroll down and read it. Next. So this is the location where Visual Studio Code will be installed. So if you want, you can just browse and change the location. I am fine with the default one. Just click on next and next as well. And here you can like create a desktop icon, and it's always good to have this one. Just check this. Okay. Action to Windows Explorer. Yeah. Better to give check everything and just click on next and install. Such a simple installation process. Okay. Yeah. So once the installation is done, just click on launch Visual Studio Code and click on finish. So this is the first interface that you will be getting after you launch Visual Studio Code. So you can like change the theme. There is light contrast, dark is the standard stuff. So the first thing what we need to do is we need to just open a folder. So for doing that, you need to just go to file and you need to click on open folder. So let me just go to desktop and basically create a new folder for Java. You can literally do this anywhere. So after going here, just right click, and here you'll be having an option called as new, and you need to go to folder. Just name it as Java project. All right. And you need to just select that and you need to click on select folder. So now we have opened the Java project folder inside our Visual Studio Code, and there are no contents inside it. It has no files. All right. So you'll be having here a plus file option like that. Click that, and here you need to enter the name of your Java file. So let me just go with first pro, like the first program. And after giving the name of your file, you need to have the .java extension. So just click on .java and you need to just hit enter. So basically you'll be having this Java over here, and here also in the bottom you'll be having this Java. All right. And here it will ask you, do you want to install the recommended extension pack from Microsoft? So just click on install. All right. So this basically will get installed for us. And in case if you want to change the size of your font, you need to just click on this settings like icon, which is called as manage. Click that and you need to go to settings, and here you'll be having this font size. So basically you need to enter 45 or 40. That's a decent and standard size of font. All right. So once you're done with this, just close this and our extensions thing will be installed. And if you don't get this automatic recommendation from Visual Studio Code, what you can do is you need to go to this fifth option over here, which is called as extensions. Just click that and you need to just search for Java. You need to just search for Java, and I think the first one that you get is extension pack for Java. You need to click that and you need to like install it if you haven't installed it. All right. So once you're done with that, basically we need to restart our Visual Studio Code. So just close and open VS Code. All right. So after restarting our VS Code, now we are good to code. So let's just go with our class. So it's going to be public class, and you just saw, right, we are getting this automatic intelligence and recommendations. So that is because of this extensions that we installed right now. So public class, and you need to name your class. I will just go with first pro, which is the name of my file. So it's always good to have your class name same as your file name, otherwise it may throw some errors. Open it, and we need to have our main function. So it's going to be public static void main, and in some cases you will be getting this automatically. So if you don't, you can just like type it out. It's going to be, you know, string with a capital S. You need to have this square bracket and you need to put a space. It's going to be args. Yeah. And this is it. This is basically the standard boilerplate code. And let's just like print hello world. That's what everybody does. So for printing, we will be using the system.out.print. So if you just type sys, you'll be getting this sysout thing. So just hit enter on that. You'll be getting this automatically generated. So I'll just go with hello. I don't want world. I'll just go with hello. That's good. And let me just now save it. So for running this program, you have two choices. So let me show you the two ways. So here in the top rightmost corner, you'll be having this triangle-like icon, which is basically the run button, and you'll be getting this run button enabled only when you install your extension, and after installation you need to restart your VS Code. So just click on this run button, and here you can see that I'm getting the output over here in the terminal. This is the first way. So let me just now close these things, close the terminal. Yeah. So let me just go with the second way. If you don't want to use this run thing, what you can do is you need to just hover over this file name and you need to just right click it, and here you will be having an option called as open in integrated terminal. Just click that, and basically you will be getting this terminal. The main thing why we need to do that is we will be having the path of our file. So here you can see that I'm having Java project, and here that path is there. So you need to be in the path where that file is present. All right. And here we need to run the command java c space your file name with the extension. So this command is used to compile. All right. First pro dot java. Hit enter. So if you don't have any errors in your program, the compilation process will be successful and you'll be getting this dot class file. All right. So now we need to view the output. For viewing the output, it's going to be only Java and your file name without the extension. All right. And just hit enter. So here you can see I'm getting the output over here also. So these are some of the two ways how you can run this thing, and I hope you would have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done many tutorials in Java, C, C++, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL queries, as well as CRUD operations using Node.js and Spring Boot, 3D animation using Blender, as well as UI designs by Figma. Check them out. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.